We'll be learning how to make basic animations in Macromedia Flash 8. You can go to File, Start New and a new Flash document. Now this Flash document contains a stage, and this is the stage, this is the timeline or the frames that we can use. This is the layers. We'll be discussing different layers, and you can click on the arrow to see the properties. You can click on the stage and the properties of the document will be appeared. You can click on the size. The size you can apply some document properties like title, description, dimensions, frame rate, and you know, so you don't need to change anything here, but you can change the color. You can have the title and you can change the frame rate. We'll be discussing the frame rate later on. Now this is the toolbox. We have the first the selection tool and the subselection, a free transform tool, then a line tool, a lasso, a pen tool, the text tool, a oval tool, and a rectangle. When you click and hold the rectangle, you can see you can have the polystar tool. We'll be using this to make stars and different other shapes. The pencil tool, brush tool, then we have the ink bottle, and the gradient, the fill color, paint bucket tool, eyedropper tool. You can use an eyedropper, you can select the already present colors on the stage like this. And we have the last, the eraser tool. We will be first discussing different modes, drawing modes. The first is where we're drawing an oval. This is the stroke color. Stroke is the outline. Right now I have selected the red outline or the stroke as it is set in the flash, the red color. Then this is the fill color, the inside color of the oval. Using the properties bar, you can change the thickness of the stroke or the outline, and you can change the type it has. And this is our first oval. While pressing shift key while drawing the oval, you can make a perfect square. I'll be making undo because I want a thicker stroke, thicker outline, and I've made it 10. Using this will be very clear that while drawing, using the brush tool, what are the different modes available, drawing modes. And this is our, you can see the circle. When the circle appears with the mouse cursor, it means it is a perfect circle. Now the drawing mode, and the brush color I will select as pink. This is the size or the thickness of the brush, and this is the type. Like, we have different angles, and right now I have selected a simple circle. Now these are the different modes. The first mode is a paint normal, and you can see it just simply paints over everything. Then we have the paint fills. Now see clearly, it only paints the fill color, not the strokes. Then we have the paint behind. It paints behind the drawn shape. We have paint selection. Now this only works when there is some kind of a selection, like you can select any part of the shape or the stage, and like this one. And when you paint over it, only the selected part will be painted. So this is very useful when you need to make special areas different colors. Then we have the paint inside. For paint inside, you can see when you click and select, again it is simply drawing as a paint behind. But what is actually happening, you can see I will draw more and two more shapes, and then you can understand that what is actually happening. Then again, let's draw using our paint inside tool and make a fill. Now when you start drawing, you can shape, and it will only form whenever you start drawing, it will only fill that shape, either it is the stage or any other shape. Now all the explanation is given in the handout provided with this video. So now there are very cool things that you can do with all the blending modes or the brush modes, and you can make some very different and very nice shapes. And we now see what's the line. A pencil tool, you can make simple pencil, and there are two modes for this one, straight line and a curve. So basically you can again use the line tool to make stick figures, to make different other shapes that are require lines. So all these are the basic shapes, the oval, the circle, the rectangle, the line, that can be used to make very different shapes. The same properties are available for the line tool, for the pencil tool, a type, the color. Now this is the dashed line, and you can see the difference. It is drawing as a simple line, but when it's done, it becomes a dashed, then you have dotted line and a rect line. It's just, it's not straight, but it's just not uniform at all. Now coming back to the frames, this is the first frame that we are drawing, where we are drawing everything is the keyframe. It is indicated by a black circle. When I insert a simple frame and then have a simple black and keyframe, a blank keyframe. Now, as I said before, the keyframe is the one that has the key changing content. A simple frame is whatever it copies from behind. I have moved the keyframe to the right side, to the frame number maybe above 35. A blank keyframe is a simple keyframe, but there is nothing on it, so you can draw something different, or you can clear the keyframe by using the right click and clear keyframe. Now we have two keyframes, the first keyframe and the second keyframe. The second keyframe, I just want to make some changes. When I inserted a keyframe, everything was copied from the previous keyframe. And in the current frame, you can change whatever. So I'm just selecting and moving different shapes here and there. You can use the selection tool to move the objects, select and move the objects. But there will be a problem if I'm correct. There might be a problem with this one, because a motion or animation requires objects. Using the selection tool, you can use the selection tool to change the lines, to change the curves. Whenever you move the cursor over, it changes the curve as well. Now we have the two keyframes, the first and the second frame. You can select in the middle, right click, now this one, the create motion frame, and this is our problem, because it is now changing as a whole, because it was a simple drawing, so it did not happen with the motion frame. I will hide and lock this layer, and I will start work on a new layer so that we can understand the keyframe. So insert new layer, you can rename it as well. This is how you hide and lock. I'll create a simple oval and insert a keyframe. In this keyframe, all the oval will be copied from the previous one. In this one, you can use the selection tool, move it anywhere else, right click and create the motion frame, and you can see our simple motion, a straight line has been created. And you can either use a mouse to check your movie. I have deleted the other keyframe now, or you can go to control and start moving. Now you can see this was a little jerky, so you can increase your frame rate per second, means how many frames will be run in 1 second. Then again test your movie, again it is a little bit jerky. there's a jerky motion, so you can insert more frames in between to increase the number of frames that will be run in 1 second, so it will be a more smoother animation. Still jerky. Oh, I will add more frames. Or change the frame rate to 30. And a little bit smoother. Now this is a straight line motion from left to right. You can also go to the properties of the oval and make it rotate clockwise or the anti-clockwise, and then test the moving. So while moving, while in that vein, it will rotate. And this is in the clockwise motion, and it can move anti-clockwise as well. Now that was a very straight line. Now what if you want a curvy motion or any other motion? For that, you will add a motion guide, and you can see there is a guide for layer 2, meaning how you will guide the motion on this layer. You can use the pencil tool and draw your motion. Right now I want just a very curvy motion. Now it will be made from the first and all around the motion tree. Zoom in, and then you can use the selection tool to select your shape, and you have to snap it to the starting point of the motion. It will be basically, you can snap it to the any point of the line, but right now I will just do it. Now how to know your snapped it properly means you cannot move it away sometimes. And now to the other side, on the other keyframe, zoom out, select the other keyframe, and on the other, like, ending position should be the other point of the line. Zoom in and use the selection tool again. Now sometimes it will be a little bit tricky to actually snap your object to the line. It will not attach itself. As you can see, you can still move it away, and you don't know that is it snapped or not. So you can click on the circle in the middle of this of the oval, and then when you move it over the line, you can see it changing to a big circle. It indicates that it is actually snapping. And then of course, again, see, you click on hold and then move it, drag it over there, it will change to a big circle, meaning it has snapped. Now you can check your motion using the timeline, and it is rotating and moving along the path. As we had done it as a rotating both, then you can test the moving. So this is how you use a motion guide. You can add more frames so that it has a very smooth animation, a slow animation. Add more frames, make it slower. As more frames are added, and we have the frames per second is 30. Now you can see that the time elapsed, the frame number is 40, the frames per second are, this is the first frame, and the time elapsed is 0. So when you move to frame number 30, you can see that our time lapse is 1 and exactly 30 frames have passed. So it shows that it's actually 30 frames per second. Then again, you can see at the last to check how much time does the total movie take. This is, and the frame, the current frame 101, the frames per second 30 frames. There are different things, to try not to change anything else because they are not even included in your course. The document I am providing with this has all the information. These are the different painting modes, these are the different examples with it. Now we have done with the frames, the layers, a simple blank keyframe, a blank frame, a keyframe, a motion tween, motion guide. I'm highlighting those that are done. Frames and layers are also done. Now coming to the shape tween. Add a new layer, and if you see that it is coming inside the guide, you have to click and drag it outside. because this is very important, because whatever layer is inside the guide, it will be using that motion guide. I'll be making a new layer, a red ball animation, and I will show you different shapes, tweens that can be done, hiding the other layer. This is how you hide using the ball under the eye and how you lock. Now I'll be making a red ball with a different multicolor ball. Let's make a multicolor ball. As you can see, we have previously selected a rugged line, so I'm changing the stroke to a normal solid line. Hairline is like very, very thin. We'll make it a solid. Let's make it like a simple ball with four colors, and you can use, of course, line. Okay, let's make a darker, a thicker stroke outline. Let's use the line tool, and we will use the cursor to curve the line so that it looks like a 3D ball. So the selection tool. Now, use the selection tool. But there is a problem, because it's a simple shape. So whenever I'm curving the line, it is the intersection is making it as two different lines, but I want to move it as a single line. This I don't want. So what to do? I will undo and change this line, and then I will draw the other line. But again, I think, let's see, I have the problem. I see the selection tool. Yes, it is now taking it as two different lines. So how to do that? Let's try. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to undo, make a line separately. We'll curve the line accordingly. Selection tool, and then curve the line, and then select and move it over the ball. And then, but I want it a little larger, like a bit longer, so you can use the pointed cursors to change it. And okay, Control Z. Anything happens, just press Control Z or undo. Now I want to have different colors on the four sides, so you can use the paint bucket tool. And the reason is this is happening is that there is a small space between the line and the stroke of the ball itself. So I'm going to, let's first color this one as green. And first make a line. The brush is bigger. Let's use the line to just join the two sides so that we can have two different parts of the ball. And you can try. Yeah, happened. Now we have our four sides, four different color multi ball. Now we'll be adding different different motions to it. Now it's not important that every layer can have only two keyframes, because this was a question that was asked to me. You can have many different keyframes, and on each keyframe you can change the position of the ball. So we'll be discussing that. We'll be seeing that. This is our last keyframe for now, but you can have just go in the middle and create the motion tree. You can select any frame and then move the ball away from its original position, and it will add a keyframe automatically. See, move the ball away to another position, a keyframe will be added because you have changed the position of the ball itself. So now our ball will move from around the corners of the stage. And this is how you add, like we have added five keyframes in one single layer. And each keyframe is going to the different position. As I said, we will be seeing all the shapes. So I'll be making a new layer named as shapes. You can rename your layer. And I have hidden all the other layers and locked them. Now in the shape, I'll be just using a circle, simple circle. And the last Okay, let's do it here in the another in the middle. In this keyframe, I will use a simple the selection tool to just use the curve and changing the curves of the circle. And you can make a very different custom shape. Custom is something that you create yourself that is not defined in the computer. Now when you add the motion tween, the shape tween, how to add the shape tween? Select anywhere in the middle. Instead of creating the shape tween, you right click, go to the properties, and there's a tween option. Right now the tween is none. If you cannot see your properties toolbar, you can go to the window and select properties and the tween, and you can see it is a green filled with an arrow and the shape changes to the one that you have made. You can make another keyframe, change the shape again. Make anything that looks like smooth change. Again, add the tween, go into anything, select anywhere in the middle and select tween and shape. Now on the third keyframe, I want to copy the first one, that is the circle, and I want to change my shape back to the original, that was the circle. Insert the keyframe and then select and delete this. You can press the delete key on your keyboard and right click, paste. So that is the original circle. So instead of making a circle again, you can use copy from the keyframe, tween and shape. Now let's see, circle to another shape and back to the circle. And either you can change the color of the shape as well, or you can change the size also. In the color, you can simply go to the second keyframe and change the color and apply the shape tween. The color will change from red to yellow, and you can see it's a very blend of the colors. Then in the last keyframe, I will change the size using the free transform tool. In the last keyframe, I want to make it like very tiny. And you can make it anywhere. It should be go back in the center, or right now it is going to the bottom left corner. I want to move it to the center. Control Z and free transform. So I'm trying to make it so that it squeezes into the, minimizes into the center. So I'm basically only the free transform tool you can use to change the shape of, change the size of your shape. Again, select anywhere in the middle and apply the shape tween. Now let's see all the animation, all the layer. You can go to control and test your movie. All the layers will be visible. We have all the shapes. So now there's one shape missing, and where you can want to change this completely. From, for example, a circle to a square, you can delete the current shape and change it to the circle, to another shape. So I'm going to move my keyframes. You can click and drag your keyframes, zoom in using the zoom tool. Then click and drag. So you have to be very careful because sometimes, see, you're not able to select. So click and drag the keyframes. So I want to add more keyframes. Let's move the circle here and okay, that's before this, insert keyframe, and in this keyframe I want to delete this and make a square. Have all the different types of shaped wings. Within the same shaped wing, you can change the color, the size, the shape itself, apply all kinds of shapes, and you can even change the position. In this, we have in the same position, you can change the position as well, and in the same shaped wing.